Okay, so for the carbohydrate foods, we've got really nice portable options. So like crackers and muesli bars. I personally like a muesli bar that combines fruit and nut, in which the nut also helps to increase the amount of protein in the bar. And I tend to choose bars that don't contain too much sugar. So I think a nice tip will be to look at the ingredients list and see if sugar is the first item on the ingredients list, then maybe that's not such a good option. Okay? Another option over here is some instant foods like instant bibimbap. This can be really easily reconstituted with hot water, mix it up and ready to go. And I've got pre-packaged bread, and the nice thing about this is it's not really easily squishable. So it's a very nice source of snack, if you wish. And plus, instant noodles. So instant noodles have got quite a bad rep, but you can find some better options out there. So I'll have a tip on how you can create a balanced meal out of instant noodles later on.
Okay, so the next category we've got here is protein. For athletes, protein is especially important for muscle repair and recovery. So here are some really portable options that you can bring for overseas. We first have this chocolate milk powder, really popular among the athletes because chocolate milk is a really good food first recovery kind of drink to have because it combines protein, carbohydrates, electrolytes and lots of vitamins and minerals for your recovery. Another good one is peanut butter. So, you know, there are many different brands out there, but we specifically chose those which are natural, meaning they have no hydrogenated fat added. Usually you will see a layer of oil on top, and that's just naturally from the peanuts itself. A really good source of protein in this compared to, you know, jams or Nutellas which don't have much protein. Another good portable source of protein is actually your canned tuna. So if you pick one which is in olive oil, it will have more omega-3s, which are anti-inflammatory for the athlete or any active individual. Next on the list, we have nuts. So another great source of healthy fat in addition to protein. Again, really portable. You can bring it, you know, to your training ground. Snack a handful in between your meals if you get hungry. And lastly, over here, we have shelf-stable braised eggs. Great source of protein. You know, eggs are one of the best quality protein on earth and quite economical as well. You can add it into your instant noodles if you need a quick source of protein. So here we have got protein. Next up, we'll move on to antioxidants as well. You know, so exercise, high-intensity exercise actually creates quite a lot of free radicals in your body, which may damage your cells and hamper recovery. So if you include a range of colourful antioxidants food, it can slow down your creation of free radicals. So right here we have got blueberries. If you don't like blueberries, you know, cranberries or raisins, they are all good sources of antioxidants. Surprisingly, chocolate is also on the list. However, we are going for dark chocolate, which has higher cocoa content. 75% and above dark chocolate will be a good source of antioxidants. Moving on to also Japanese green tea, matcha, or you call matcha, good source of antioxidants. So this is different from the commercial green tea you can see on the shelves, which is mostly sugar. And lastly, we also have got another dried fruit, tart cherries. This interesting fact is that it contains natural melatonin, which can improve the quality of your sleep. This is the brief introduction.
Okay, so if you're an active individual or if you're an athlete, we highly recommend the athlete's plate as a reference as to how to choose your food groups. So for carbohydrates, we term it as the goal foods because they give fuel for your muscles. For protein, we term it as the grow foods to help rebuild and repair your muscles. For vegetables and fruit, they are your glow foods because they give you antioxidants for its anti-inflammatory properties. If you are traveling, portable options like instant noodles and an example here would be the bibimbap are really nice sources. For a healthier instant noodle option, you might want to look out for non-fried noodles and check out if it contains the healthier diet pyramid over here. Okay, and to verify that, because it's non-fried, it has been air-fried or baked, it has 0 grams of fat. So if we were to make a meal out of instant noodles rather than just eating the noodle by itself, you could choose to include some canned tuna or some instant eggs for that protein, quality protein. And you can combine this with a sauce of vegetables. Over here we've got corn as one option, but otherwise you've got frozen vegetables or either canned mushrooms. That's up to you to choose. And all these will constitute a balanced athlete's plate.